In this video, we'll try to understand how to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram in case of a simply supported beam carrying moment and a point load. Now the arrangement of the beam is as shown over here. So it is simply supported at points A and B. It carries an external moment of 2 kN at a distance of 2 m from the left hand support and a point load of 4 kN at point D at a distance of 2 m from the right hand support. Now the first thing is we want to find out these reactions RA and RB by applying the conditions of equilibrium. So the first condition of equilibrium is summation of forces in y direction is equal to 0, considering upward forces positive and downward forces negative. So RA and RB, they are acting in the upward direction, and 4 kN force, it is acting in the downward direction. So RA plus RB minus 4 is equal to 0, or we can say that RA plus RB is equal to 4. The another condition of equilibrium is summation of moments is equal to 0. Clockwise moments we have considered as positive, whereas anti-clockwise moments they are considered as negative. Now taking moments about this point A, we'll start with this RB. So the arrow of this reaction RB will go in the anti-clockwise direction towards A. So it is minus RB, and from B up to A, the perpendicular distance is 6. So as it is in the anti-clockwise direction, it is negative sign that we have used. And from B up to A, the perpendicular distance is 6. So it is minus RB into 6. Then this 2 kN, that is already a clockwise moment that is acting. So that plus 2 we have added over here. This 4 kN force point load will create a clockwise moment, and the perpendicular distance from D up to A is 2 plus 2, that is 4. So it is 4 into 4, that also we have mentioned over here. So it is 18 is equal to 6 RB, or RB is equal to 3 kN. Now from equation 1, we can say that RA is equal to 4 minus RB. So substitute the value of RB, and therefore we'll get value of reaction at A is equal to 1 kN. Now we have to draw the shear force diagram, and the conventions for this shear force diagram, their upward forces are considered as positive, whereas downward forces they are considered as negative. Now shear force at A, we are having an upward reaction of 1 kN, and it is positive. Then at C left or C, there is no force that is acting between A and C. So whatever is the shear force that is acting at A, the same will be acting at left of C as well as at C. Then shear force at D left will be same, because no force is acting from A up to just left of D without considering this 4 kN point load. Now exactly at D to this particular 1 kN, there is a downward acting force of 4 kN. So it is 1 minus 4, that is minus 3 kN. At the left of B, it will be same, because there is no other force that is acting between D and just left of B without considering this reaction. Exactly at B, it will be minus 3 plus the upward acting reaction of 3 kN, that is 0. Using these values, we can draw the shear force diagram. So first we'll draw the reference or baseline. At A, it is upward acting shear force of 1 kN. It will remain same up to point D. Again, exactly at D, it is minus 3 kN. It will remain same at the left of B, and at B, it will be 0. So these are the values which we have obtained at various points, and those are mentioned on this particular diagram. The next job is to draw the bending moment diagram. The conventions for bending moment diagram, they are clockwise positive and anti-clockwise negative. Now bending moment at A will be 0. Just left of the C, without considering this external bending moment, we are having reaction RA, which is acting in the upward direction and producing a clockwise moment about C. So it is 1 into 2, that is 2 kN. But exactly at C to this 2 kN, again there is a clockwise moment of 2 kN that is acting, so that get added to this. So total will be 4 kN. Now we have to find out the bending moment at point D. Consider all the forces and moments which are acting on the left hand side of T. Start with this reaction array which is acting in the upward direction. It will produce clockwise moment about D. So from A up to D, the perpendicular distance is 4. So it is 1 into 4. And already there is an external moment of 2 kN meter in the clockwise direction at C. So total will be 6 kN meter. And bending moment at the end of the beam is 0. So using these values, we can draw the bending moment diagram. So this is 2 kN meter at the left of C. Then exactly at C it is 4. Then it increases to 6 kN meter at D and reduces to 0 at B. And these are the various values which we have indicated on the diagram. So in this way, we can draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of a simply supported beam carrying an external moment and a point load. Thank you very much for watching.